one little task, right? And you're still kind of coupled to that guest OS. It's kind of hard to upgrade that without doing a lot more work. So that's the first version where it is using a managed VM instance group. Each VM was running a single job. And then based on the pipeline, or the PubSub QDEP, we're just spinning up and down different amounts of machines to handle that load. You know, but this was really not that efficient. A single VM to do one video, that seems like we can get a little bit more efficiency if we bin pack a little. So how do we do that? Of course, the new way is containers, containers, and containers. How many of you have heard of Docker in here? All right, some of you. So if you have not heard of Docker, you can think of it as a even lighter weight VM. Instead of emulating the whole computer, we are only emulating from the kernel up. So the kernel is shared between all our containers, but again, it runs the Linux operating system type stuff, the user space libraries, all in an isolated environment. So like a BSD jail or Chroot, things like that. What this allows us to do is run a lot more of these apps on the same machine, right? So we get more efficiency per machine. Cool thing at Google, we have an open source product called Kubernetes. How many have heard of Kubernetes? A few? Okay, cool. So Kubernetes is our cluster management software. And basically we have a commercial version of that called Google Container Engine. So I made a container engine cluster, I created my Docker containers, and I stuck it on, right? And surprisingly, using the same infrastructure, right? Same compute engine infrastructure backing these workers, but because we're using Docker containers and really bin packing a little bit more efficiently, got almost a 3x utilization increase with no changes to the code, which is really nice, right? We were doing some dumb stuff before, like running a job per VM, which is kind of overkill, but it was so easy to move to containers. Oh, thank you. So just to kind of recap, we talked about App Engine, which, you know, has the least flexibility, but the highest developer efficiency. You have to kind of adhere to our standards because it's a platform as a service, but it's really easy to scale up. You don't have to think about management at all. And then you have the highest flexibility and the least efficiency with Compute Engine because you had to manage your own Linux installs, right? Which can be a pain sometimes. And then kind of the Goldilocks sweet spot is Container Engine. You get kind of that scaling and that automation and that management somewhat for you. At the same time, because it's running Docker and containers, you have that flexibility as well. All right, so now each of those guys extracts a single frame using that audio signal. And then we have another worker that's going to pull from those frames and stitch it all together into an MP4. Then that MP4 gets downgraded and file size increased into a GIF because Twitter. Yeah, that sucks. But, and we come out with a GIF. All right. But how do we kind of do all that stuff with the stitchers? We're using all this stuff, right? So we have the database. That every time the extractor says we're ready, we're uploading an image. We're using those cloud those notifications again. And then how do we know that every single phone has finished, right? Well, we can tie it back using Firebase. Now, Firebase knows the status of every single phone because it knows it's finished uploading and finished taking. Once every single phone says, I'm done, once every single stitcher says, extractor says, I'm done extracting, Firebase says, we are good to go, and it shows that image on the screen. So now we'll go into our remote live demo, because live demos are not scary enough. Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
All right, so here we have our Cloud Spin rig set up in the back corner for you guys to also use after the show. Ray is in. Go, Ray, go. He's getting an App Engine. So Ray is in the center of the rig. On the count of whatever Kathy says, he's going to jump, and then we're going to hit a button that's going to trigger it to take a to mark that frame, right? So all those phones are all going to upload video. So, Kathy, when you're ready.
Ready?
So you can see them all go yellow. I'm going to switch to...
Go.
You didn't see him jump. That's okay. This was happening right now. Believe me, he jumped. So all the phones are starting to upload their video. This is going to be a little bit slow because of the Wi-Fi. I'm going to turn off my thing so I don't suck up bandwidth. Turn that off. All right, cool. So we can see that. We got most of the frames uploaded. We have one more phone. Wi-Fi is our biggest bottleneck. Usually we have dedicated Wi-Fi, but conferences, right? We'll wait for that one to finish. So you can see that once it uploads, the extractor is extracted really fast. So that is processing. It's going to cloud storage. Then cloud storage is going to hit App Engine. App Engine is going to put it into the notification. Once that notification is in PubSub, the workers on our container engine pull those frames. Once the frames are pulled, they stitch together, and the output GIF comes out. Yay. All right. So in recap, So in the recap, basically what you remember is we have all the devices which are completely off the shelf, nothing modified here. They all upload video to the cloud storage bucket. The bucket hits the notifications. The notifications go into PubSub. The PubSub spins up extractors. The extractors take those frames, stick it into another queue. Then the stitcher stitches them all together, and we get our nice picture. And then Firebase says, here you go. And then you can see all that UI was all Firebase as well. So yay. And you must memorize all of those as well. All right, so I am not the brainchild behind this. Instead, it is really good round of applause to Brett, Frances, Kathy, and Ray, who were the team who built this in 3 weeks, which is impressive. And thank you guys so much. Follow me on Twitter and all that good stuff.
Extractors which are used, they are like a set number, or they depend upon the number of frames that have to be extracted?
So right now, what we can do is, based on that PubSub queue length, we can actually spin up and down more extractors as we need them, right? So if we have a 200 different cloud spins going around the country, right, and then each one is taking pictures, we can scale them up and down depending on how many pictures are being taken.
Extractors are up on the cloud?
Yes. Yes.
So they can be dynamically
created. Yes. And some cool things about running on the cloud versus doing it locally is we can reprocess these as many times as we want, which means that we can do cool things like put different filters on. Ray, do you have that one with the video? You want to just pull that up real fast? We can do a lot of cool things because we have all the raw data, right? And we never lose that data. We can reprocess and do cooler and cooler things that maybe the first time we didn't think about doing. So we have some ideas, like you can pick which frame you want out of all of them, and then it will generate multiple cloud spins for you. A lot of cool stuff. So Ray's going to pull up some other kind of hacks that we did with cloud spin. Here's one. So here, you can see this one. I'm going to restart that. Same hardware. It starts the video and then goes into the matrix and then stops, right? So you can do stuff like the Trinity, like the little thing. You can do all that kind of cool stuff. And because we're doing it on the cloud, there's no change to our hardware. Like, you can go install this in a mall kiosk and then do all this in the back end, iteratively, right? Which is really cool. Thanks, Ray. All right, any more questions?
So is this thing on GitHub that we can download?
Good question. Not yet. We're going to clean up the code and hopefully put it up on GitHub. Our plan is to open source all of it. Uh-huh. Because it was written in 3 weeks, yeah, you don't want to see the code right now.
And the next thing is it both on Android and iOS, or just on iOS? So
this is just Android right now. There's no reason why this won't work on iOS, because Firebase works perfectly with iOS as well. Okay. The problem with using more than different phones is each phone has different video hardware, right? So we're trying to keep the factors as consistent as possible. Mm-hmm. We actually use Moto Gs in Europe, and it just, like, weird things were different, right? You think 1080p video is 1080p video? Apparently not. You could be able to just pull your phone out, download the app, and then have tons of different types of phones, and just set up a cloud spin like on the spot with everyone in this conference. Exactly. hopefully like version 2. We have a lot of ideas for version 2, and normalization is definitely one of them. No question. Any more questions? All right. If there's no more questions, remember that CloudSpin is in the back. Your picture is only $5. No, I'm just kidding. It's free. I gotta pay for this somehow, right? My boss is gonna be like, "What happened?" But yeah, just go to the back, sign up, take your picture. If you've already taken your picture, good for you. But yeah, guys, thanks so much.
It's great.
Okay, so I'm gonna bring up the agenda again. It's at only 1:35 right now, 1:36. We can possibly start the next session a little early, which would be great, because then we can have longer time for snack.